गुड मॉर्निंग सर, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू?
यस मैम, अभी स्टूडेंट्स के पास मैंने लिंक भेजा, अभी ज्वाइन करेंगे अभी स्टूडेंट्स।
ओके, 5-7 मिनट में वेट कर लेते हैं।
और आने लग गए।
हेलो सर, ये इंडक्शन प्रोग्राम है सर ये?
हाँ जी, हाँ जी, इंडक्शन। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
गुड मॉर्निंग,
लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस स्टूडेंट्स। गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग। ओके, वी शुड स्टार्ट अवर लेक्चर नाउ। लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस टुडे स्पीकर डॉक्टर मीना कुमारी। शी इज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एट गवर्नमेंट ट्रेनिंग कॉलेज पन्नीवाला मोटा, and she is also head of applied science department at government engineering college Pannivala Mota. She has teaching and research experience of about 20 years. She will introduce you with some communication skill techniques. Let madam, we should start our lecture. Madam Meena Kumari.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Good morning, all the students.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Today we'll be talking about on communication skills in English, and especially we will focus on the common errors which we commit when we use English as medium of communication. As you all know, English is a foreign language for us. It's not our mother tongue, and it is not easy to master English. It is a long process. It takes a time of years. But if we consciously make efforts, then nothing is impossible. As today's topic is communication skills in English. Communication, you know, it's not a new term for you. We communicate from early morning to late evening before we go to bed. We communicate with our parents, with our teachers, with our friends, with other family members. So communication goes on. And if we are using English as medium of communication, then it is a bit difficult because we are not getting proper medium for communication in English. Throughout the time, we communicate in our dialect, whatever it is, Haryanvi, Rajasthani, Punjabi, whatever. And we communicate in Hindi in our colleges. But as you are the students who are going to be engineers, English is medium of communication for us. So let's start our topic, communication skills in English. And we'll also learn about some of the common errors. They will be helpful for you. At least you won't be committing those errors in your communication. So let's start. I'll present my screen now. So wait, by the time I'm presenting my screen, if you feel any problem, you can stop me and tell me about that. If you feel problem in understanding what I'm speaking, then also you can stop me. And if my voice is not properly audible to you, please let me know. Okay. Please tell me whether the screen is visible to you or not. Screen is visible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm waiting for your response.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
And I'm audible to you all?
Yes,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let's start. Communication. We have just talked about what is the communication. If we talk about the definition, it's a process of sending and receiving information. We
Hello, ma'am. Aap ki awaaz clear
tell others what we want to tell them.
And, hello.
Okay. Ma'am. Awaaz slow aa rahi hai. Awaaz nahi aa rahi hai. Cut nahi aa rahi hai. What's the problem? Hanji, hanji, bataiye. Aapki awaaz to sahi aa rahi hai. Meri awaaz cut ke aa rahi hai ya?
No, ma'am. Clear hai.
मैम क्लियर ही आ रही है मैम क्लियर आ रही है
क्लियर है
ओके चलो किसी पर्टिकुलर स्टूडेंट की नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम हो सकती है तो आप एक बार दोबारा ज्वाइन कर सकते हो उसको वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट कम्युनिकेशन एक जनरल टर्म है उसका हमारा मीनिंग क्या है दैट वी सेंड इंफॉर्मेशन वी रिसीव इंफॉर्मेशन दिस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन मीनिंग ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन different forms of communication are verbal communication or we communicate orally like when we communicate on telephone we speak to other person and convey our message there is written form of communication also when we send an email a letter or write a report on a particular topic or a project then we use the written medium of communication Communication is also a very difficult task and we need a particular skill for communication. है ना communication इतना आसान नहीं है हमें उसके लिए भी skills acquire करनी पड़ती है. What do we mean by communication skills? Having required abilities to express oneself effectively so that others may understand you and you can understand others. ठीक है ना communication skill जो है उसमें आपको ऐसी abilities require करनी पड़ती है acquire करनी पड़ती है वहां पे सुनने वाले आपको समझ सके और आप सुनने वालों को समझ सके किसी तरह का कोई बीच में डाउट नहीं हो, किसी तरह का कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं हो, ठीक है ना। और उसके लिए आपको क्या चाहिए होता है, मतलब आपने एक कम्युनिकेशन को इफेक्टिव कैसे बनाना है, फॉर दैट पर्पज यू नीड टू पे अटेंशन टू सर्टेन पॉइंट्स। ओके, व्हाट आर दीज? सम ऑफ द पॉइंट्स आर रिटन हियर, एक्टिव लिसनिंग। Now you'll be feeling like, what's the need of active listening for the effective communication? It's very important. One thing like active listening involves hearing and understanding what a person is saying to you. आपको समझना है सामने वाला आपको क्या कह रहा है, क्या पूछ रहा है. Unless you understand clearly what a person is telling you, you can't respond appropriately. जब तक आप समझेंगे नहीं कि सामने वाला आपको पूछना क्या चाह रहा है, how will you give an appropriate answer, a direct answer, a sleek answer? That's why active listening is very important. You should pay attention to what is being told. People do not like communicating with others who are only interested in telling you what they want to tell you and don't listen to what you have to say. You must have come across in life jo sirf kehne mein vishwas karte hain, zyada attentively wo sunte nahi hai. They simply want the others should listen them. Theek hai na, is tarah ke log bhi milte honge. तो क्या होता है, कम्युनिकेशन इज ए टू वे प्रोसेस. आप सामने वाले की बात सुनते हैं, सामने वाला आपकी बात सुनता है, एक दूसरे का कहा हुआ समझते हैं एंड यू रिस्पॉन्ड. एक्टिव लिसनिंग विल हेल्प इन दिस टास्क. तो फॉर इफेक्टिव कम्युनिकेशन यू शुड बी अ गुड एक्टिव लिसनर ऑल्सो. फॉर इफेक्टिव कम्युनिकेशन वी नीड नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन ऑल्सो. Or we can say non-verbal communication also helps in making communication effective. In non-verbal communication, there can be body language of the speaker, tone of your voice, your hand gestures, your eye contact with the listener. These are the important tools which help in communication. जब भी आप कुछ बात कर रहे हैं, अंटिल यू आर स्पीकिंग ऑन टेलीफोन, योर जेस्चर्स, योर बॉडी लैंग्वेज ऑल्सो टेल अ लॉट ऑफ मीनिंग दैट यू आर कॉन्फिडेंट और नॉट. दिस विल बी कम्युनिकेटेड बाय योर बॉडी लैंग्वेज एंड अदर थिंग्स लाइक व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ रिलेशनशिप यू बोथ ऑफ यू स्पीकर एंड द लिसनर आर हैविंग. दिस विल ऑल्सो बी शोन बाय द बॉडी लैंग्वेज. इफ यू आर हैविंग फ्रेंडली एंड cordial relations, then there will be a smile on your face. If you are not having good relations with each other, then some sort of seriousness will be there on the face. Like body language, your gestures, they also communicate a lot. But tone of your voice will also send the message effectively, what you want to send. So we need to pay attention to all these things when we are trying to learn good communication. Whatever we communicate, the content we want to convey, that should be concise. Concise ka matlab hota hai brief. मतलब बहुत सारे शब्दों का यूज करके और आप मतलब थोड़ी सी बात को कहें, दैट्स नॉट समथिंग गुड. बिकॉज एक्सेसिव यूज ऑफ वर्ड्स विल मेक योर लिसनर टू लूज हिज फोकस और मेक इट डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट यू वांट टू से. बहुत ज्यादा शब्द आप यूज करेंगे तो द लिसनर वोंट बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड यू प्रॉपरली. एंड इफ यू विल बी सेइंग इन डायरेक्ट मैनर, टेकिंग मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ वर्ड्स, इट विल एक्सप्रेस यू मोर क्लियरली एंड the listener will be able to understand you immediately. And in present time, nobody is free. Everyone is busy and they don't have time to listen to you for a longer period of time. We are phone pe baat kar rahe hain, the same thing which could have been conveyed in 5 minutes, and you keep on talking on the issue for 15 or 20 minutes, then it is not considered good. Dusra aapke phone is tarah se aayega na, to wo sochega ek bar uthane se pehle ki usne lambi baat karni hai, theek hai na. तो जो कम्युनिकेशन का कुछ लोग की आदत हो जाती है कि दे यूज एक्सेसिव, दे मेक यूज ऑफ एक्सेसिव वर्ड्स व्हाइल कम्युनिकेटिंग, दैट इज नॉट समथिंग गुड. गुड कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स इंक्लूड द एबिलिटी टू एक्सप्रेस योरसेल्फ कंसाइसली, ब्रीफली. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज कॉन्फिडेंस ऑफ द स्पीकर. Whether the listener will be listening to you attentively, it depends on your confidence. Like, how confidently are you expressing yourself? This will create desired impact on the listener. If you have given a thought to the message in advance, which you want to convey, you will be confident while speaking. आपने ये सोच लिया हो अगर कि आप क्या कहने वाले हैं, then you will be confident at the time of speaking. And if you are confidently saying something, others will believe it. आप कुछ सच भी कह रहे हैं, but you are not confident while saying that, people may not believe you. ठीक है ना? तो confidence जो है वो भी जरूरी है. आप जो कह रहे हैं, यू शुड बी कॉन्फिडेंट इनफ. अब जो लिसनर है आपका, यू शुड बी पेइंग प्रॉपर रेस्पेक्ट फॉर हिम. वो आप कैसे रेस्पेक्ट पे करेंगे? इफ यू एड्रेस द लिसनर यूजिंग हिज नेम, addressing him by using his name, this will also be conveying him the meaning that he is being appreciated, he is being given importance. ठीक है ना? आप उसको importance दे रहे हैं. दूसरा, आप कैसे listener को respect करेंगे? Communication, as you know, it is a two-way process. You'll be saying something and the other person, the listener, he will also giving his views. He will also give his views. So if you accept his views open-mindedly, and if you agree with his views, you say it clearly. If you don't agree, then also you give your arguments, your response in a very polite manner, not hurting him, then this will also create a sort of impression on the listener that you respect him. If you respect him, definitely he will be listening to you attentively. Open-mindedness of the speaker, this also helps him in becoming effective communicator, because you are not stick to your views blindly. You should be open enough to accept others' views. Dusra jo keh raha hai, agar wo sahi keh raha hai, you should not hesitate in accepting them. ठीक है, उन व्यूज को एक्सेप्ट करने से हेजिटेट अगर नहीं कर रहे हैं, यू शुड बी फ्लेक्सिबल इनफ. तो आपके बारे में कहा जाएगा कि यू आर क्वाइट ओपन माइंडेड, एंड दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ एटीट्यूड इज रिक्वायर्ड फ्रॉम अ स्पीकर. इफ द स्पीकर इज हैविंग ऑल दीज थिंग्स, पेइंग अटेंशन टू ऑल दीज थिंग्स, देन द कम्युनिकेशन विल बी क्वाइट इफेक्टिव. लेट्स कम टू द लास्ट वन, दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट. Command over the language being used. Suppose you are using English and you are not having proper command over English, what will happen? it will create all the problems. Like the content is there in your mind in Hindi and you are not getting proper words to convey it, to say it. Then aap effectively nahi kar payenge. While conveying the message, you will be taking help of pillars. Pillars ka matlab jaise kuch log bolte hue is tarah ka kuch karte rehte hai na, us waqt wo kya kar rahe hain, they are taking time to collect vocabulary, to remember vocabulary for expressing the ideas which are there in their mind. So command over the language which is being used for communication is the most important thing. Hai na, ab hamari majboori hai whether we know English or not. We have to learn it, we have to use it in our conversation. If we don't start using it now, we have to use it after completion of this 4-year degree course, after completion of BTech, when we you'll go for an interview in some multinational company, they won't allow you to use Haryanvi or Hindi. And in the manner you will start English, tutti frutti English, like if you haven't started now, to kya hoga? They will immediately recognize that if they select this person, it may not be good for the reputation of their company. ठीक है ना? तो आपको this is the right time that you start paying attention to what sort of English you are having till now and what sort of improvement you want, so that by the time you complete your course, you may make yourself proficient in communicating in English. Okay, so let's start some of the common errors in English. Kuch common errors ki baat karte hain jo hum aam taur pe commit karte hain, errors when we use English in our communication. So I have chosen some 32 errors at least, or you won't be committing them in your communication. Aaj ke baad aap unko commit nahi karenge. Okay, now there are 3 sentences and you please read them. If any one of you know how to correct them, he can unmute his mic and tell me what is the correct one. And if you don't know, then keep your mic mute and I'll be telling you how to correct them. Okay, so the first one here is, I have an urgent work at home. It seems correct, nahi lagta to theek hi hai, but it's not. The second one, she has sold all her old furnitures. ये भी सही लग रहा है वैसे तो, कि उसने अपने जो भी पुराना फर्नीचर उसके पास था वो बेच दिया सारा. Let's come to the third one. My father gave me many advices. है ना, बहुत सारी बातें बताई मेरे फादर ने. He gave me many advices. This also seems to be correct. Okay, anybody from the students want to say something? कोई कुछ कहना चाहेगा? ओके, नो कंपल्शन फॉर यू. नाउ यू लुक एट दीज सेंटेंसेस. एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू? फर्स्ट टेल मी प्लीज. एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
ओके, नाउ फर्स्ट सेंटेंस इज करेक्टेड इन द सेंटेंस नंबर 4 हियर. प्लीज लुक एट दिस सेंटेंस हियर. The correct version of I have an urgent work at home will be, I have an urgent piece of work at home. An urgent piece of work at home. Why? Because
please repeat.
Why piece? Haan, haan, main wahi bata rahi hu. Urgent bhi nahi, actually do. ये जो वर्ड है ना वर्क, W O R K, वर्क इज एन अनकाउंटेबल नाउन हियर. अर्जेंट तो है वो एक मॉडिफायर है, एक एडजेक्टिव है विच इज यूज्ड टू एड समथिंग इन द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड वर्क. भाई काम कैसा है, इट इज अर्जेंट, है ना, अनअवॉइडेबल है, अर्जेंट है, करना है. तो ये अब जो वर्क है, वर्क इज एन अनकाउंटेबल नाउन. आगे वाले दो शब्द और देखो, फर्नीचर इन द फिफ्थ सेंटेंस, एडवाइस इन द सिक्स सेंटेंस. ऑल दीज थ्री वर्ड्स, दीज आर अनकाउंटेबल नाउन्स. अनकाउंटेबल नाउन्स क्या होती है? नाउन इज अ वेरी सिंपल वर्ड. अगर मैं आप लोग को वैसे नाउन पढ़ाती, मैं कहती कि हाँ, इन कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स इन इंग्लिश एंड वी विल टॉक अबाउट नाउन्स, यू विल से मैडम क्या बात कर रही है, we have started learning noun from our very second third class and ma'am will talk about noun at this advanced stage. But noun is a very vast field. We may not have paid attention to this part of noun and what are the rules related to this particular part of noun, which is called uncountable noun. Uncountable nouns will not be used with a or n before them. The error in the sentence number one is that I have used n here. This n is actually for the work, but it is written a. It is written n, not a, because this urgent, this adjective precedes work, and as this adjective urgent starts with a vowel sound, it will take n. Possibly I have made myself clear. Jo work hai, actually uske saath hum articles use karte hain, adjective ke saath nahi karte hain. Par usse pehle agar adjective likha hua ho to hum article adjective ke pehle likhte hain. Hai actually wo us noun ki wajah se hi, aur जो एडजेक्टिव का जो पहली साउंड आती है उसके हिसाब से ए एन वगैरह आप यूज करते हैं. तो यहाँ पे जो ये एन अर्जेंट है, एन जो यहाँ पे लगाया है वो वर्क की वजह से लगाया है. एंड वर्क इज एन अनकाउंटेबल नाउन. अनकाउंटेबल नाउन विल नॉट टेक आर्टिकल्स, ए एन वगैरह ये आर्टिकल्स नहीं लेंगे. तो प्रॉब्लम